Were you talking about grams rather than calories?
On the left-hand side was the calories,
yeah,
and on the right-hand side was the actual volume of food that tied to those calories.
Because you were saying don't count calories.
Yes.
But it would be great to see that left side in in the grams.
Oh, okay, I could do that.
Do you know what
that's
I'm saying? Because
idea.
It's hard to change the
calories. Yes.
We're not counting calories.
Yes, good point, good
yeah.
point. In
yeah.
grams.
Yeah.
Yes. Very good idea, I'll do that. Sodium. When you're on a ketogenic diet and when you're intermittent fasting, your lower level of insulin is going to cause your kidneys to remove all excess water. And so that also means you're going to excrete sodium from your bloodstream. And you might get headaches, fatigue, fogginess, muscle cramps. So you've got to eat more salt.
Good salt.
Good salt. Especially in the early going, the first couple of weeks until you adapt. Okay? If your symptoms increase your intake of sodium and green leafy vegetables, and that'll increase your salt. And you can also drink stock, clear broth, sea salts, there's organic marmite, they're all sources, good sources of salt and minerals. A lot of people ask about alcohol. I gotta say, alcohol is a neurotoxin. So it kills your nerves.
Yeah.
It's a hepatotoxin. It kills your liver. It is one of the primary causes of fatty liver disease. But more than that, it drains your motivation, lowers your inhibitions, impairs your driving ability. But at the same time, we all want a glass of wine or something. And if we do, stick to the drier wines. Stick to the harder liquors, not the more sweeter alcohols. It will, if you're trying to lose weight, it may stall your weight loss from 24 hours to up to a week. So if you're trying to lose weight, alcohol may not be the best thing in the early going. How do you cook? You should cook with as much as possible with animal fats which are rendered and have a high smoke point. What you don't want is a fat that's oxidized. You can use your vegetable oils and salads, raw and cold pressed, and they've still got all their antioxidants and polyphenols, and they're very good for you. You can use coconut, olive, sesame, peanut, any other monounsaturated oil. Animal fats, lard, tallow, butter, ghee. Butter has a lower smoke point, but the rendered fats have a smoke point of 450 degrees, or thereabouts. If you want to use the vegetable oils for cooking, please cook gently with them. Don't smoke them, don't overcook. And do not reuse your frying fats. They have trans fatty acids, which are very, very bad for you.
Okay, now wait a minute. Do not reuse frying fats. You mean like if I have had a chicken that I roasted and it's given me fat with a little juice or something?
You can reuse it, but not when you have a vat of oil in which you have fried French fries and then you use it to fry chicken.
Oh, I see. Oh,
so,
that kind of
yeah,
fat.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
I could
no,
use the
yeah,
chicken
absolutely.
Fat to sauté.
In fact, that's a very good question,
yeah.
which is, if fat has rendered out of the food I'm cooking, please use that fat for your eating purposes.
So for cooking, I don't use olive oil because I understood that it was not a good idea. It's also expensive. So I'm using coconut oil, but I am using the unrefined. And I'm using palm oil, red palm oil.
Yes.
Are those okay?
Those have a lower smoke point. The expressed, cold pressed oils in particular, so heat, warm it gently, fry it very gently. If you want to do high temperature scalding or braising or broiling,
yeah.
use the rendered animal fats. They have a smoke point of 450 degrees.
Mm-hmm.
These will burn.
How come olive oil is not good? Olive oil is good.
Very low.
It's very good for eating, but not as good for cooking at high temperatures.
So, toasted sesame oil has more flavor that's good for certain dishes. Is that
you can use
not
it
good or is it?
Well, you can use it. It's already toasted, so it's been heated before.
Mm-hmm.
But you can use it. It's a monounsaturated oil, but I would say for cooking, you know, use it sparingly. Use the cold pressed. I would prefer the cold-pressed oil for putting in salads simply because it has all the antioxidants still there. With a little dash of the toasted oil for flavor.
Avocado oil, that's
sure, yeah. but not grapeseed oil, not rice bran oil, not corn, all these new fattish oils. That if it's polyunsaturated, avoid it. You should store all your oils in a cool, dark place, avoid margarine, and make homemade salad dressings. Those are very interesting, and the store-bought salad dressings have a lot of sugar in them, and just junky oils.
Well, yeah, they're all soy oil.
They're all soy oil.
And they're usually in plastic bottles.
Yes, yes. If you feel you're not getting enough fats in the day, just chop up some bacon bits, some cheese, some boiled eggs, and that's the way to enhance fats in a meal. So if you've got a bed of lettuce, just throw these three things and it'll have lots of fats in it.
Eggs have fat.
Great source of fats, all of these. Great sources of fat, sardines, you can chop them up cold and put some garlic and olive oil, the great key, lard and tallow, coconut oil, butter, sesame oils. So all of these are good fats to use. They're monounsaturated or saturated. And then use condiments to emulsify these oils so that your digestive ability is enhanced. All of these things help you digest your oils and fats better, which is why they're added to your salads and salad dressing. So you use these and you can make, you know, you can make 9 different types of salad dressings. You can make a blue cheese, a roasted garlic, skip the honey mustard, classic vinaigrette. That's for you.
Yeah.
Peanut lime.
Why
I mean, you can make
honey mustard.
Well, it's got sugar in it. The honey, it's got sugar in it. But yeah, that's not for diabetics. But you can eat the, you can make these and keep them. You know. And a little bit of honey, this is,
yeah.
So I'm making the distinction between diabetics, not so diabetic, and regular people, so just pick and choose. But the point here is make your own salad dressings.
Yes.
They're awesome.
Yes.
And it takes literally 30 seconds in a mixer, blender to make them.
Make a big batch and just have
exactly.
A jar.
Yes. Exactly.
I just made some this morning.
Yeah. Exactly. Fake sugars, avoid them. And this brings us to what you can eat. So the green, so I've divided this into, this is based off of Tim Noakes's book.
Can you give
the,
us a list of that?
I will send you this list.
The whole thing. Right?
And the whole thing. The green list is all the stuff you can freely eat. You can eat all of this at all times. Artichokes, asparagus, aubergine, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, cabbage, gourds, cauliflower, celery. Look at how many choices you got to eat. Cucumber, endive, gherkins, dill, sugar-free though, green beans, kale, kohlrabi, leeks, lettuce, frozen vegetables, mushrooms, okra, onion, pepper, red, green, yellow, pumpkin, radishes, sauerkraut, seaweeds, chayote, or how do you say it, spinach, spring onions, squashes, sugar snap peas, tomatoes, turnips, and arugula, all okay to eat. Animal protein, all eggs, beef, mutton, veal, lamb, pork, duck, turkey, organ meat, seafood, no problem. All dairy, but it has to be whole fat. Do not eat low-fat dairy. It's laden with lactose, which is a sugar. It's very high carb. It'll get your insulin levels up. Buttermilk, coconut milk, full cream, hard cheeses, soft cheeses, cottage cheeses, sour cream yogurt, Greek yogurts, Greek cheeses. If you're trying to lose weight, in some people, dairy will stall weight loss. So just be aware of it, and maybe later on you can start eating it and a little bit less early on.
Mm-hmm.
All the fats and oils, beef, tallow, butter, duck fat is awesome, cold pressed oils, all the nut oils are just fine.
Do you know how you make buttermilk?
Yes, from yogurt. You just put water in it. Or kefir, put water in it, put spices. The moru is essentially buttermilk.
Oh, yeah?
And in the process of making butter, you take the fat out, and what's left is
right.
A sort of fatty beverage of curds and whey. All the nuts, almonds, Brazil nuts, all the nuts are okay, but remember, more than 100 grams of nuts have 10 grams, 9 to 10 grams of carbs. So if you're a person who cannot stop eating nuts once they start, then you may want to hold back a little bit. But a handful of nuts, absolutely essential. Beverages, tea, coffee, green tea, soda waters, sparkling waters, but no sugars. Try and use flavorings and condiments that are natural herbs instead of mixes and, you know, sauces that you buy in a store. You can use every single herb and spice there is out there. You can use stevia leaf if you must, or erythritol, but most artificial sweeteners are very, very toxic and not good for your health, especially neurological health.
Would I have that jar?
Yes, absolutely. I'll mail it to you. This is the orange list, and these are things that you eat once in a while. So what we're not saying is you can never eat it, but this is stuff you can eat gobs and gobs, lots and lots of. You can eat all the avocados you want, all the olives that you want, but when you're eating fruits, understand that fruits contain carb grams and eat them a little sparingly on the ketogenic diet, or you'll get thrown out of ketosis. Certain proteins have more carbs, certain sweeteners and nuts have more carbs. Cashew nuts have a lot more carbs than the other nuts. Certain vegetables, the underground vegetables, of potatoes, etc., are all, or they're not even on this list, but some of these are high carbohydrate vegetables like artichokes, beetroots, carrots that are boiled, carrots, leeks, parsnips, squashes, butternut squashes, very sweet potato. So you can figure it out that some of these are sweeter, mm-hmm. are higher in carbs. So use those sparingly and use the fruit very sparingly. You can still have some berries, but look at the carb content of these fruits and then eat accordingly. So you're in charge of what you eat. The red list is a no-no on the keto. And for people who are especially allergic to grains, all grains and starches, but look at what you can eat. There's a whole bunch of foods you can eat. At its simplest, a keto diet is a bunch of vegetables, a little piece of meat slathered with fats. How simple is that to make? Very simple to make. The red list is all breads, all baked goods, croissants and pastries and cornmeal and matzo and oatmeal and rice.
You're making them hungry.
Hitting all the buttons, couscous, lentils, pasta, polenta, rice, split peas, wheat germ, wheat straw. All of these are sugar and drag, or sugar in another cloak. And so these are red list items for people who are insulin resistant. All beverages that contain dextrose and maltose and so on. All alcohols that are sweet, beer, ciders, dessert wines, liqueurs, and shooters. And all low-fat dairy or processed dairy is a big no-no. Fats and oils, anything that is hydrogenated, polyunsaturated, dried fruits, terrible, commercial sauces, barbecues, sweeteners, agave, and all these newfangled sweeteners, avoid them. Maple syrup, carob syrup, corn syrup, mannitol, saccharin, terrible. Table sugar, tapioca sugar, treacle. Try not to eat fast food at fast food places. If you do go to an In-N-Out burger, ask them for a burger with the lettuce wrap.
I thought blackstrap molasses was really good for you.
It's good for you, but not if you're trying to be ketotic. It has a lot of sugar, and it'll instantly raise your insulin levels. So yes, it is very rich in minerals, but it's also very rich in sugar.
I see.
And you can get a lot of those minerals elsewhere, especially if you're insulin resistant. Meat and fish, anything that's cured, got nitrites, all the packaged things, sausages and cured meats with salamis you can find uncured,
yeah.
And with natural
ones.
Celery salts, those are very good. The Fermani ones are very good. Crumbed and battered meats, crumbed chicken. And for the crumb, you can use Parmesan, you can use coconut flour, and get exactly the same results without the carbohydrates. And so your sample meal plan is really simple. You have a small bit of protein, a fat source, and you can have bacon, eggs, cheese, oils, fats, and the fat source, and a low-carb vegetable, which needs to form 70% of your plate volume. Lunch, you can have another protein fat source. You could have salad dressing, cheese, cream, avocados, cup and a half of salad greens. If you want a snack, eat something that is low carbohydrate and has peanut butter and celery sticks, almond butter and carrot sticks, or other sticks, ikama. Dinner, again, the same thing. So simple meal plans are very simple. They're very simple. But the key here is the green list. If you eat off of this, if you eat intermittently, in about a month or so, there will be remarkable changes.
Yeah.
If you've had your blood chemistry tested, get it tested after 6 months.
What do you say about almond milk? Why it's not?
It's very processed. It's very processed. You want to eat the almonds, you want to soak the almonds and just eat the almonds direct.
Oh,
avoid the milk. It's in dioxin-laden containers, which is very, very carcinogenic.
We made our own almond milk by soaking the almonds and putting it in the blender. And
you can do that.
You put the take the skins off.
You could take their skins off or leave them on, but it's up to you. So that's the ketogenic and intermittent fasting diet. If anyone wants to do it, our club of wall, Facebook wall, feel free to email, ask questions.
Yeah.
I'm gonna say it's good for about 70-80% of us.
Mm-hmm.
I would recommend 3 or 4 meals in your window,
mm-hmm.
and many more carbohydrates. But can I
still do the intermittent fast?
Absolutely, it'll be very, very good for
mm-hmm.
you. Celiac is an autoimmune disease,
mm-hmm.
and your digestion will improve. And you have insulin resistance, so that'll
mm-hmm.
be very helpful.
So can you send us this whole
yes.
PowerPoint
yes.
presentation?
Yes.
I mean, not just this, but that.
I will send you this whole
today,
PowerPoint.
So that we know how to eat
yes,
tonight.
Yes. And so if you're totally confused, just stick to this. If you're totally confused, you can take this to the grocery store. You can eat all of this. You can eat all of this.
Yeah.
And there you go.
Yeah, she sent you.
I have a question. What does the word keto mean? From where?
That's a good question. Keto comes from the word ketone, and a ketone is a big fat broken up into little parts called ketones with 2 carbons. And so the diet is a ketogenic diet, meaning it's going to inspire your body to make ketones
Great.
Instead of burn sugar.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.